No question about it, because let's be honest about it. When a man is that big and important a star, the older people here will remember that Ed Sullivan was the very biggest star in the country. On Sunday nights, nobody watched anything but Ed Sullivan. Mm-hmm. Anybody under 25 here probably never even heard of him, but he was a superstar of his time. And when I was on his show, it was considered being the biggest thing in the world. It was almost like being on your show right now. Mm-hmm. See, now you like me a little better, I notice. I knew I was in trouble there, too. I figured out I got to get him back here fast. But the point is that when I did this joke, it was just a meaningless joke. He was telling me I got 2 minutes left, so I started to kibitz with him. I said, you got 2 fingers for me, I got a finger for you. And I started to joke around with fingers. I didn't make a dirty gesture, and I didn't even know about a dirty mm-hmm. gesture. The fact of the matter is I'm in show business now 27 years, and to this day I have never told a dirty joke.
Yeah.
It's not my character. Right. I don't enjoy dirty jokes, and I don't tell dirty jokes. And that's why it was a tough struggle to become a hit with clean jokes.
Yeah.
So when I decided that I'm going to just give him a little kibitz that meant absolutely nothing, he misinterpreted it as a filthy gesture and immediately announced that I was banned from the show. And yeah. all of a sudden, I got an image as the dirty comedian. Being a dirty comedian today is like a badge of honor. It's almost impossible to make a living without being a dirty comedian.
Yeah.
But in those days, a dirty comedian was a symbol of the fact that you couldn't be trusted. He was unpredictable, untrustworthy. To stay away from him, I was considered like somebody nobody could...
Yeah.
Nothing.
But now, if you did something controversial on TV, you'd probably end up being some of our highest paid comedians, Andrew Dice Clay, Sam Kinison, controversial guys.
It's not the opposite. The dirtier, the better. People love dirty jokes today, and the very dirtiest comedians are the biggest stars in the country. Let's be honest about it. Eddie Murphy. Just not dirty and fictitious. Eddie Murphy is not dirty in pictures. In pictures, he does the script. Mm-hmm. But when you see him doing a one-man show, I spend the whole show walking around like this. Because for an old Jew, these are new jokes. I never heard of. But to the youth of America, this is in.
Yes.
This is in. If you do one whole joke without a dirty word, people are wondering what happened. He forgot his act. Because that's what's hot today.
Yes. Let's take a commercial and come back with what's hot today, Jackie Mason.
For the very first time on any stage right about here, here is a really fine actor. He just returned from Saudi Arabia and he brought back a little...
So there's a lawsuit, the impression.
Right. And after that, everything sort of straightened itself out. A couple of Gentiles saw me who decided I wasn't too Jewish. And they took a chance with me on this chicken soup idea with Lynn Redgrave.
Mm-hmm.
And it looks like I'm in the middle of a big hit.
Yeah.
And I only came here to tell it to you because I tell you right now, I don't need you no more. Actually, I'm crazy about you. I really am. There's 3 other white late night shows, right? All with white hosts. But you notice, I came here. Now, I don't believe in color lines. I'm making jokes about color. People are all the same to me. Till I saw you, I liked everybody. But the truth of the matter is, it's not a question of color. I happen to think that you're a genius at what you do. I don't know what you do, but whatever you do... If I find out what you do, I'll tell everybody. But see, I didn't want to do the Johnny Carson show because I honestly found out that you're doing better than him in a few cities already. You're not supposed to mention this, but you're the first person who's been successful enough to be able to compete with a legend like him. It doesn't put him down. It just means that I am an intelligent person. And I didn't take a look at the people, I took a look at the numbers. There's one more for you, that's where I go. Even though I don't like you personally, I don't know what I mean.
Let's talk about politics, because you did your one-man show in Washington, D.C. recently.
That's right. I did the one-man show, and I was a huge hit over there, too. I don't like to show off. It's not my nature. But I was a very big hit there for 6 weeks, and I met the president and the vice president, and they all came to see me. They couldn't get over what a hit that was. The whole government was coming to my place. And now I got involved in politics. I'm supporting Giuliani for mayor in the city of New York, because Koch has been putting one crook in office after another. And Giuliani has been putting them in jail. So I think if Giuliani has to put them in jail, we could eliminate the middlemen and put Giuliani into office and have them honest in the first place.
Yeah. We're out of time, man. You got to come back again.
Oh. I was just getting started. What happened?
You got to come back again.
God bless you. We have to come back, too, because without you, I'm not going to do the show.
Thanks for being here. Jackie Mason.